Honda dealer.
Monday Morning Running Back, sponsored by your Northern Ohio Honda dealers.
No touchdown for either team.
Well, it wasn't pretty, but the Browns equaled their win total from all of last season by taking advantage of some pretty big mistakes. You know, we are all Monday morning quarterbacks, yes. But he's our Monday morning running back.
Yeah, former Browns running back Greg Pruitt is here after every game, the day after, right?
That's right. Yeah. We're smiling today. Yes. So he's here to help us figure out what went right and what went wrong against the Raiders. So first question, let's talk about the running game. 39 yards rushing. What do we need to do to get the running game back on track?
Well, I don't think they quite have figured out who they want to put in certain situations. I think Tate is an inside runner, and he's a very physical runner. Not because he wears the number 34, but I'm a little disappointed that he did not play as much yesterday. And I think he is not their third best back. I'm not going to say where he's at, but I don't think he's their third best back. And we got to figure that out. But the running game, having young running backs and having what has happened to the offensive line, certainly you have to rely on your experience as a running back to get the tougher yards, because linemen make backs good, but also backs can make linemen better.
Yeah. And so yesterday, big defense produced the big plays and really won the game for
us. Well, the thing that happened yesterday is our defense, we're still giving up big yards running, but we bent, but we didn't break. Mm-hmm. And we turned the ball over when we had to, and the Browns have failed to put points on the board as a result of turnovers by the defense. But yesterday, we turned that around. So nice. We're making improvements.
Joe Hayden, one of the highest paid corners in the league. It's after all the talk about, you know, he's not playing up to his level.
Right.
Yesterday, he really answered all the critics.
Yeah, well, you know, we played a team that certainly I don't think was better than we were. And we should have beat them. And a lot of people think we should have run them out of the stadium. But, you know, any given Sunday, anybody can beat you in the National Football League. And the Browns, another part of being a good team is you win ugly games.
Mm-hmm.
A win is a win. You find a way, despite great play and despite bad play and a lot of mistakes, you find a way to win. And the Browns did that yesterday.
Gibson had another interception.
Oh, yeah.
So what do you think? He's having a Pro Bowl season so far?
Well, some guy just happened to know where to be when the ball's up in the air, and Gibson is one of those guys. I mean, all our defensive backs yesterday played well. We managed to create a pass rush by doing some creative things, and luckily we had a young quarterback, and they took advantage of him. They forced him to make mistakes, and we capitalized on those mistakes.
I know it's early to say, but we're 4-3. Pretty good. We haven't been here in a long time.
Well, you know, beginning of the season, nobody gave us a chance.
Yeah.
And to this point, we still have not put our 11 best guys on offense, either because of injury or because of being suspended.
Yeah.
And so if we can win some of these games and be in contention with Josh Gordon comes back, and hopefully he can have the impact that he's had when he was in here, it'll make a big difference.
Do we know the latest on Cameron's injury?
I'm not sure, but I thought he came back and played a little bit.
Did he come back?
Sure. Yeah, he came back and played.
His bell
rung.
Yeah,
he got his bell rung.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Running through all the concussion tests and that kind of stuff.
So
here we are, 4-3. Cincinnati won yesterday. Pittsburgh won pretty handily yesterday, too.
Yeah.
What do we got? And we got Josh Gordon coming back in about three games.
Mm-hmm.
Can we make it to the playoffs? What do we have to do? We play in one of the toughest divisions in all of football. What do we got to do to get that
next level? I guess that's where I was getting at, but you got to go right in there, right?
We got to figure out how to get our running game back on track.
Yeah.
And it's no question that the injury to our line has affected us, and we haven't figured that out. And you got young backs, and then you got a young offensive line with the key guy, the center. I mean, if you had to pick a guy that you didn't want to get hurt, it would be the center.
Mm-hmm.
And we've been unlucky in that category, but you know, sometimes the ball got to bounce your way. It did yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
A couple of passes by Hoyer probably should have been intercepted, but they wasn't. But that's a part of the game. You got to take it. It was ugly, but it's a win.
Mm-hmm. Next week, they're 1-6, right?
Right.
Another opportunity for us.
But I don't even look at that. I mean, you got to prepare the team regardless of their record and try to exploit their weaknesses. And that's what we have to do, because everybody's going to do the same thing. You know, I watch this Big Cat Diary every morning. And when a lion kills something, you get the vultures from everywhere. Then they come, I mean, they come from anywhere. And so in professional football, when somebody figures something out and they take advantage and gives you problems, you're going to see it week after week after week until you resolve it. So these teams get a week to prepare and watch this film, and you're going to see some of the same thing. And hopefully we can expect the same thing and try to resolve it and try to make them pay for the things they're going to try to do for us, do to us on defense.
So nice to have the conversation going from, you know, well, we might get 4 wins this year, maybe 5 wins, but now we can puff our chests out a little bit, get at least 8-8, might get 9, who knows, but it feels good to be a Browns fan right now.
I want to say that yesterday I went to the game, and I guess a lot of people were upset that Crowell wasn't in, and I heard some chanting about Johnny, and we got to get away from that and do what we supposed to do, be the 12th guy. We have to make it as difficult as possible for that opposing team. So let the Browns do their job, and the Browns fan, let's do ours.
That's right.
True. That's so true. Yeah.
Perfect.
That's good.
You're the man, Greg. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Greg Pruitt will be with us after every Browns home game next week. The Browns take on the Tampa Bay Bucks the week after that. I believe it's Cincinnati, and hopefully we can rattle off a couple more victories. Thanks
every
so much.
Monday.
Hey, thank you, guys.
Love it. We like to see you smile when you come in the morning.
Well, when they win, I can't do nothing but smile.
I know. That's why I said you look extra happy today.
Yeah.
All right, 8:34 this morning. Let's check in with Scott. See how the weather's shaping up.